According to a 2013 national survey on drug use and health, about 5.4% of pregnant women between the ages of 15 and 44 actively used illicit drugs at the time of the survey, and around 9.4% reported that they were active users of alcohol. Dr. Lisa Bergeron explains that any amount of drug use is bad for the development of an infant with prenatal drug exposure.
When it comes to use of any type of illegal or legal drug during pregnancy, there is absolutely no minimum level of drug that should be consumed. When we see any type of drug being taken by a pregnant mom, it can have an effect at any time in the development of the baby. What we see is that the amount or the number of drugs and when it is taken during gestational age has an effect on the developing baby that can have an impact for that baby's life.
The most common types of drugs used during pregnancy are nicotine, alcohol, marijuana, opiates, and methamphetamines, carrying many harmful effects before and after birth.
What we find is that most of these drugs, except for marijuana, affect fetal growth. So they affect the growth of the baby while the baby is in utero. What then we find after the baby is born is that there are still these effects in these little ones' systems. And it affects overall some of their neurobehavioral symptoms that you see right after birth. They are more irritable, they're difficult to soothe, they may have trouble feeding, they may have high tone, they're just having a hard time adapting to their environment, which is a result of exposure to these drugs in utero.
How are these symptoms treated?
We try as best as we can to calm these babies, to swaddle these babies. Many times they need a little bit extra calories too because they're expending a lot of calories because of the irritability and fussiness. And so to try to keep them in as quiet as environment, swaddled, kind of close to mom if at all possible, so that we can help to prevent some more of the signs of neonatal abstinence syndrome.
Symptoms of neonatal abstinence syndrome may not appear until days after the baby is discharged from the hospital. This is why universal screenings for mother and baby are crucial.
If we have a baby who has prenatal drug exposure and it's a vaginal delivery and they go home in 48 hours, that baby may start to have withdrawal signs and symptoms at home. This leads to more issues and maybe not even knowing what's going on with this baby that they need further treatment. So it's really important to know beforehand if we have a baby that has been exposed to drugs so that we can watch for these signs and symptoms and not let that happen at home.
Dr. Bergeron explains that a hospital and community effort is the most effective way to set up the mother and her baby for success.
If that child has any issues with their development, because that is common, and again, learning and behavior later on, again, the importance of intervention services, whether it's speech and language for those delays or special education help for those areas of cognition that are impacted by that drug exposure, or behavior, because we see ADHD or other behavioral concerns. We tend to see more aggressive types of behavior in these children. If we are in an environment that can recognize that early, that will help impact how that child does later on in a more positive direction.
This has been Making the Rounds, brought to you by Parkview Health.